What's up, guys? I'm Ethan Enns. Welcome to the Ethan Enns Show. We are covering the topic of Christian bands that have just stopped making music at some point or another. And they're great bands, they put out great music, and it's just a shame that they've stopped making music. So I'm going to be listing 6 Christian bands that need to make a comeback. Like right now, please. So basically, I'm going to go through each of these 6 bands and I'm going to break down the history of the band, when they stopped making music, and also talk about how much of a possibility there is of them returning and making a comeback. And the first one on the list is none other than the legends DC Talk. Yep, that's right. You know I had to include them on the list. I'm a big fan of DC Talk. I mean, they're legends in the Christian music industry. They're really cool. So honestly, I shouldn't have to give you this introduction, but I'll give you a little bit of an introduction for anyone who isn't super familiar with DC Talk. But honestly, how are you not? Like, have you been living under a rock? So basically, DC Talk is a rock and rap trio consisting of Toby McKeon, also known as Toby Mac, Kevin Max, and Michael Tate, who is the current lead singer of Newsboys. They were together as a group for 11 years, and in those 11 years, they put out 5 major studio albums. Their last studio album, Supernatural, was released in 1998. After that, they kind of just stopped making music. However, they never actually officially disbanded, so technically, they're on an indefinite hiatus. In fact, in 2000, they released a greatest hits album titled Intermission, leaving the door open for some form of reunion in the future. Since then, as far as new music, DC Talk has been featured on a few Toby Mac and Kevin Max songs. Most recently, DC Talk was featured on Toby Mac's song Love Feels Like from his 2015 album This Is Not a Test. In 2017, they announced the Jesus Freak Cruise, where DC Talk and Newsboys, Toby Mac, Kevin Max, and more would perform. And there was also another Jesus Freak Cruise in 2019. And all that sounds cool, but the only problem with it was how much it cost. With prices being anywhere from $650 to $1,000+, honestly, it just made it not very accessible or affordable for most people. Personally, I think a world tour would be a way better idea. As far as them making an actual comeback and making new music again, I think it's pretty unlikely. Or so I had thought, until I came across an article while doing research for this video, and I'm so glad I did. In an interview with CCM Magazine, Kevin Max said, "I know there's a lot of talk between us and the people who surround us about doing more than cruises. So we all know that the hardcore DC Talk fan wants something more than a cruise. That much is obvious. It's trying to align all those different careers and families and people who are taken care of through these independent musicians. Putting all that together and coming up with something we all can do is a puzzle. Beyond that, I know all of us are super excited to do more." To which CCM Magazine asked, "When you say more, do you mean tour dates or another cruise or perhaps even a new album?" And Kevin responded by saying, "I would say all of it. I'm obviously a guy who loves to create albums, and I would say I'm more interested in creating stuff rather than performing live. But the other guys love to perform live. But I think they also love making albums as well. So it's not just touring. I would really love to see us do something creative." So there you have it. It looks like there is quite a bit of hope, actually, for a tour, hopefully a world tour that comes to Canada, and even a new album from DC Talk. Just giving you guys a moment there to freak out. But when exactly is this happening? Well, we'll just have to wait and see. But seeing as DC Talk fans have been waiting over 20 years for a reunion, what's a few more years, honestly? Next up, I want to talk about FM Static. How much longer will this keep getting stronger? I wonder what she's doing when I'm singing myself to sleep. FM Static is a Canadian pop-punk band consisting of Trevor McNeven, the frontman for 1,000-Foot Crutch, and Stephen Augustine, who is also the drummer for TFK. FM Static was together as a band for 8 years and put out 4 major studio albums before they stopped making music. Their last album, My Brain Says Stop, But My Heart Says Go, was released in 2011. There was no official announcement of disbandment that I'm aware of, so much like DC Talk, they're on hiatus for an unknown amount of time. So because of that, the door is left open for FM Static to reunite sometime in the future as well. But unfortunately, there's been no talk of that happening. Personally, I think it'll be quite a while before we get a reunion, if we're going to get one. Most recently, Trevor McNeven started up a new hip-hop project called Eye in the Storm. So between that and TFK, I think he'll have his hands full for quite a while, but I still have hope that there will be an FM Static reunion sometime in the future.
Dear God, I wrote this letter
to ask you to let FM Static make another album, please. Next on the list is Starfield.
For the kingdom of
Starfield is a Canadian CCM band, which currently consists of Tim Neufeld and John Neufeld. Their last album, The Kingdom, was released in 2012.
But after 15 years in the spotlight, they suddenly vanished.
Tim said that after they finished up promoting that album, he and his brother knew that it was time to step away and each try something different. In an interview with Christian Week, Tim said, "I don't ever want to say I was bored with what was going on with Starfield, because I'm extremely grateful for all the opportunities I've had with Starfield and I'm sure will continue to have. It's just that as a creative person, I'm always looking for something that is creatively challenging. And what John and I and the guys in Starfield were doing stopped being a challenge." Both John and Tim went on to make solo music, and then later, Tim started a group called Tim Neufeld and the Glory Boys. When it comes to the likeliness of Starfield making new music again, sadly, the odds don't look too good.
Do you want new music from Starfield? Too bad.
We're not writing any.
Nope.
But after being on hiatus for 8 years, they did do a reunion tour across Canada, and thankfully, I was able to see them in concert and meet them after the show. And at the end of the concert, Tim said this.
God bless you! See you in 2027!
That was a joke, right? I mean, yeah, it probably was. But who knows? You might want to mark your calendars just in case. Next, I want to talk about Stellar Cars.
Hell to a higher call.
Is an American pop-punk band consisting of Adam Agee, Ali Shields, Jeremy Hoff, and Nick Baumhard. I probably totally just butchered those names. They were around for 13 years, and in those 13 years, they put out 5 major studio albums. Their last album, titled All In, was released in 2013. They never officially broke up, leaving the band on hold indefinitely. Adam went on to become the new lead singer of Audio Adrenaline, and they released an album in 2016 titled The Sound of the Saints. In 2017, Adam released an EP titled Paper Planes. So, what are the odds of Stellar Cart getting back together again? Well, Adam once hinted about new Stellar Cart music in a social media post. He said, "Later this fall, we're going to try to sneak into the studio and create some nostalgic SK magic for you." But that post was back in 2017, and there's still no sign of new Stellar Cart music. So although I don't think it's absolutely hopeless, I wouldn't get too excited just yet. Next up, we gotta talk about Capital Kings. Capital Capital Kings is an electronic duo that was started by Cole Wallowak and John White. They've been around since 2010 and got their start doing remixes for artists such as Toby Mac, Colton Dixon, and more. And then went on to release two major studio albums and one remix album of their own. In 2016, John announced that he would be leaving the group in order to pursue a solo career under the name Nevada. And John was later replaced by Dylan Housewright. In 2017, they released four singles, which was assumed to be leading up to their upcoming third record. But unfortunately, that album never happened. Not too long after the release of their latest single, Rip It Up, they announced on social media that they would be taking a break from music due to the birth of Dylan's child. I've read articles that use the term disbandment, and I really don't think that's accurate. In their social media post, they said, "We have decided that we are going to be stepping away from Capital Kings for the time being. If you ask me, that doesn't sound like a permanent decision." So I think it's very likely that Capital Kings will return to make new music, but I don't know when that will be. And last, but definitely not least, is Capital Life. Capital Lights is an American pop-punk band consisting of Bryson Phillips, Brett Admire, Jonathan Williams, John Odle, and Michael Phillips. They released several independent albums, but only one major label album in 2009 titled This Is an Outrage. They had been a band for 7 years before they decided to disband, which I think is honestly an outrage. I'm gonna move on. They later reunited in 2010 and released their second major label album titled Rhythm and Moves in 2012. And ever since that, they've been on a really long hiatus. All the members appear to still be good friends and everything like that, but as far as them getting back together to make new music, we'll just have to wait and see. There has been no talk about that happening, so don't really have anything to go off of, but I really hope it happens. All right, well, that is the end of my list. I really hope that all of these bands and groups reunite and make new music again. That would be so awesome. And if by chance you haven't heard of any of these bands that I've mentioned, please go and check them out. They have some great music to listen to, and I really think it's a shame that they've stopped making music. But I definitely do have hope. Out of all the bands that I talked about in this episode, which would you be most excited about reuniting? And also, are there any bands that I didn't include on this list that you would really like to see make a comeback? Comment below. Well, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy this video, if you could just hit the like button to show your support, that would be great. Check out one of these videos on either side of me here. And if you enjoy my content, please consider subscribing. You can also hit the notification bell. That's going to notify you whenever I upload, so you never miss an upload. I'm Ethan Enns, and I hope you guys have a blessed day. Peace out. Oh, shoot. Did that just die?